since I made my request on Saturday, I have in my present here a response from the Prime Minister of Trinidad and Tobago. Headline: money scarce. Money scarce. PM tells union leader paying salary is government hardest task. I would like the Prime Minister of Trinidad and Tobago to know to get my compensation package before it's too late. Please get my compensation package before it's too late. Because I also have an ex report. And this report is from the UN. The UN say history of slavery. UN say history of slave trade can help combat social injustice. I want you all to know that this testimony is from the UN. What the UN is saying after I made my call for my slave parents' reparation, this is yesterday's papers, and I want you all to follow me, you know. UN says history of slave trade can help combat social injustice. And I want Mr. Rowley to know my case is based on social and my social economic injustice. And I would like him to get my package fixed, because I am not Roger and I am not the OWTO. I am a separate entity. I am a separate entity who has a very close link with the Creator. And trust me, find these people and tell them to get Uprising compensation package together. And away with all these blind excuses. The time is far past and spent for these excuses. You cannot have a man. You cannot have a man who said that he's the Prime Minister of Trinidad and Tobago, who are responsible to account for the oil and for the gas and for the pitch and for the ammonia and for the methanol and for the natural resource of Trinidad and Tobago, and will come and tell the nation, not the nation, this included the 1%, but he will come and tell the majority, his people. He will come to his people and tell them what? No money. A slave, no money. You want money? You want a better life? But the invisible, the untouchables and the invisible 1%. That is not Rowley's statement. That is their statement. But they will remain invisible. You know why? They don't want to look bad to come to you to tell you that they don't have no money when they already informed the world that they are your new slave masters. Look at the yoke on your neck. Look at the new yoke on your neck. Look at the new yoke on your neck. That is from your new slave masters, the invisible and the untouchable 1%. But they won't come to you. They're afraid of you because you are suspect. They have their boy to come to you. They have the opposition, Keith Rowley, to come to you to bring that news of no money in the country to you. But this is the report he will give you. And sad to say that the union, who was expecting to eat the food, was very disappointed. And they are taking their stand as the most powerful ethnic group in the country. And they told the union, deal with the boss. The boss will tell you that we have no money for you. We are not going to bribe the union. You know why? We employ 6,000 of your people. What do you have to offer your people? Where is your parlor? Where is your food house? Where is your restaurant? Where is your store, Roger? You let Rowley deal with you. They give him the information, and Rowley told the nation and the union that the government had its task is to pay salary. I am warning you people. I am pleading and appealing with you people. Something is coming that they don't know about. Just how they did not know about the tornado. Something is coming for them. Mark my word. Mark my mere words. And we are going to see who is who. When the time comes, there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. There will be no place to run. There will be no place to hide. You all has bring this system into disrepute. You don't have the money. And these citizens are not seeking refugee status. They are not. They are waiting for the next 5 years to hear when these people come to ask you for your vote again. This is what you people are waiting on. While your great doctor, your great doctor, who should be attending to you and to your cry, offering your children a better life, he's saying to you and your children, the hardest task of the government is no money. But I want to tell you something though, different to that. The father of the nation, the founding father of the nation, once told the world that money is no problem. And I take this information very serious. I take this information very serious. So we have some other reporting. We have an international prime minister who had to attend court for stealing taxpayers' money. On the day of her court hearing, she flee and went to Dubai. We have in Trinidad, where Hollis and his wife have more than 444 counts of charges. One woman, the first woman, I believe she made the world record. But I am saying to you all that there are other women and other men in Trinidad right here who will beat her when you hear the right time come. When you hear the countdown come, they will make her 444 count of charges look bad. And I tell you all of these for holding my social economic rights, meaning my citizen share that is written in Trinidad and Tobago Constitution. When you hold that for me, and when you take that away from me, and you give it away to America and all this country that you're hearing about, you know that the bounty hunter is on their case. And I am saying that the Creator is my bounty hunter and my bounty is sure. I want to say good evening. And I am saying that this is the meaning of culture. When we can stand for what is ours. And when we can demand. And when we can have the kind of spiritual justice that is about to be established. I want to say good evening and thank you one more time. For this is the meaning of culture. And I thank you. I thank you. I thank you.
Uprising Cultural Warriors, community cultural outreach. Come and support the local culture. Calypso, Steel Park, the unknown artists. Come and see young and uprising stars. It's all courtesy. The Grill House, the London Strip Restaurant and Bar, Lenny Suman Car Park, and Travel Computer Technology Solution Limited. The Uprising Stars Cultural Warriors, Star Search, and Community Cultural Outreach. If you can sing, if you can dance, if you play an instrument, feel free to pop in and make a contribution culturally. This and every Saturday, from 30 p.m. to 9 p.m. See you there.
And we want to welcome you to the cultural aspect of this afternoon proceedings. Remember, we have a birthday celebration coming up, and we have a grand time waiting the kids, the children of the coffee. Remember, the time to be happy is now. Without a doubt, now I'm gonna extend a Uprising Stars cultural greeting one more. Remember that Uprising Stars Cultural Warriors Cultural Outreach Program, roll on, roll off street cultural tent. We say street cultural tent because this is where we are housing our culture. And we are saying that we are proud and honored to gather every Saturday right here on the coffee, on 119 Coffee Street. And we also invite the rest of Trinidad and Tobago to be a part of Uprising Stars Cultural Warriors Roll On, Roll Off Street Cultural Tent. Right about now, we are going to go into the program. So right about now, we are going to bring one of the founding rising stars on the coffee. And could you put your hands together for fellowship? Very talented, very gifted, very blessed.
Love in the house, love in the house. Voices. All right. How you feeling?
Good.
What is it? Good?
Good.
You.
Good.
You.
Good.
You.
Good.
You.
Normal.
Normal. You.
Great.
You.
Great.
You.
Good.
Good. You.
Good.
Good. And you.
Okay.
And you. Are you feeling real good? And you?
Good.
Lovely.
Excellent.
Lovely. Ooh. That's nice. That's nice. You know, it's just so wonderful that we could have. What's that? It's so wonderful to have lovely voice in the house. And the same in the back there. Everyone is calling out, saying they'd like to hear that girl again. That voice is too sweet. So we're going to bring her out again to do another song. Right? You love it? You love it?
You should come by me earlier.
All right.
You came by me last night.
Here she comes again. Woo. Let's give her a round of applause. Come on, baby, sing it.
Okay, thanks.
Yeah.
do down in the coffee here. Lovely voices, you know. And right now, I just want to bring on the cultural man here. The big man they call... The big man, Hercules!
Thank you one more time. Thank you, thank you. Right about now, we would go into a very special time of one of the rising stars on the coffee. We are going to celebrate Ronis' birthday with her today. Could you all put your hands together as we join and celebrate Ronis' birthday today? Could I have a lovely round of applause? So we will all join and sing the birthday song with her. Race.
Everybody.
And sing the birthday song with her, please. Race.
Yeah, Mike.
Actually,
face the camera, please. Face the camera.
Everybody come like this. Please, come like this. Come on, stand here, Rich.
Come to me. Thank you. This song is about going back home. Because I am inheritance of the two continents in the world, Africa and India. And I am very serious about going back home. So I decided to write the song to cry to my both grandparents, India and Africa, asking for refugee status. So against my will, I ask you to please join me with this song as I cry out to my grandparents, India and Africa. Come in, buddy DJ.
Smoking ganja, come la drinking punching, rowdy drinking mama, the commissioner coke and babash. Hello, hello, mother India. Hello, hello, mother Africa. Hello, hello, Trinbago. Hello, hello, to the Caribbean. Nana came from India to plant the plantation. Nani came from India to plant the plantation. Grandpa came from Africa to plant the plantation. Granny came from Africa to plant the plantation.
What I do?
The between the taxi, between the lagoon, between on the cotton field, the kill we on the slave ship. You ask me for a chance. You ride my father back. You ride my mother back. To promote and endorse slavery. Hello, hello, mother India. Hello, hello, mother Africa. Hello, hello, Trinbago. Hello, hello, to the Caribbean. From India to plant the plantation. Nani came from India to plant the plantation. Grandpa came from Africa to plant the plantation. Granny came from Africa to plant the plantation.
What I do? What I do?
Yeah, between the cane field, between the lagoon, between on the cotton field, till we on the slave ship. Talking race, only pushing hate. You want to segregate, discriminating the culture. Hello, hello, mother India. Hello, hello, mother Africa. Hello, hello, Trinbago. Hello, hello, to the Caribbean. Nana came from India to plant the plantation. Daddy came from India to plant the plantation. Grandpa came from Africa to plant the plantation. Granny came from Africa to plant the plantation. You were singing film song, you were singing banjo, you were singing tumri. It's chutney rum you're singing. Don't forget where you come from. Don't forget where you come from. Don't forget where you come from.
Forget where you come from. Uprising say so. Enjoy the rest of the show and I love you.
Well, here, the big man of the culture, don't forget where you come from. So you know what happening here? We have a big singer again, a king. He's about to come on the stage. The singer is King Solomon. All the kids they love King Solomon. So we bring it on the king. The king, what? Solomon.
Things
yes, what?
Get better with time. So my people, don't you worry. Don't you fret your mind. Things will get better with time. Ooh, my children. Things will get better with time. Love is the only answer to each and every question. So long as you care about me and I care about you, we would always be together and everything is gonna be fine. Things will get better with time. So my children, don't you worry. Don't you fret your mind. Things will get better with time. We might not have a million, not even by the thousand. So long as you care about me and I care about you, we would always have each other and take it one day at a time. Things will get better with time. So my people, don't you worry. Don't you fret your mind. Things will get better with time. Greetings, children of the coffee, and all you people on the coffee. One love, one name, one destiny. DJ Chatry. There comes a time in every man's life,
yeah, man,
when he got to make that choice. To choose wrong or right. To walk out of the darkness.
Ooh.
And into the light. Yeah, yeah. We got to get ourselves together. So we could face the stormy weather. Get our lives in order to walk see. Time removed the pain and agony. Reveal all things and fulfill our prophecy. But I give us strength to face our enemy. We got to get ourselves together. Strong, because we're living in a time where you must know right from wrong,
yeah,
and have the strength to hold on to what is right. Sometimes you might have a little battle because of the feeling you feel with things that you interfere with, things that you do, and you end up getting attached to it. And when time to let it go, it feels kind of hard, but don't give up desiring to let it go. One day you'll get the strength to let it go. Don't be hard on yourself. I have to leave now, right, because I'm going to how do you call it? Mon Diablo. They say it's not Mon Diablo, it's Mon Diablo. I have to go do a little show over there. So I thank you for the opportunity for being here tonight. Uprising Birds International, Calypso Tent, always a pleasure. It's always a blessing for this mixture. They don't know it's lightning and thunder, so something to leave with. I have been searching for someone to fulfill my dreams, to make me happy, to make me stronger. Don't beg,
jeez.
It's all this experience that everybody have to go through every day in life. So when the turn comes, just take time to understand. Experience, it's just experience that everyone is going through. It's just experience everyone is going through. Experience, it's just experience that everyone is going through. And when we come to understand, then we would know what we're here to do. Experience, it's just experience that everyone has to go through. What we have to do. Some will rise, some will fall, some have to creep, some have to crawl. Some will be good, some will be bad. Some are happy and some will be sad. That we could know the beauty that is in God. Experience, it's just experience that everyone is going through. And when we come to understand, then we would know what we're here to do. everyone has to go through. And when we come to understand, then we would know what we have to do.
Generation. We just cannot continue in this way. We must invest in them children today. Because if we don't, we will have to pay. We must invest in them children, I say. Role model is a scarce commodity in this modern society. Single parent unemployment seems to be the norm. Children leave a supervisor and I could go on. I say it, failure is not an option. It's the choices and making good decisions. Building a stronger society, we need to have a stable economy. So as a concerned parent, this is my plan. To save the future generation. We just cannot continue in this way. We must invest in them children today. Teach them the watchwords of this nation. And to live up to greater expectations. We need to encourage the youth of today. And protect them from going astray. Teach them the importance of family values. To persevere in whatever they do. The sky is the limit, that should be your goal. Put aside all the negative things of this world. Remember, you could be what you want to be. It's you in charge of your destiny. So as a perseverant, this is my plan. To save the future generation. We just cannot continue in this way. We must invest in them children today. As we pledge our lives to live, living in peace, love and unity. Peer pressure is a difficult thing to live. The friends that you keep could lead you astray. The indifference of the challenges along the way. Determination will bring you success one day. Be responsible for your own actions. And able to rise to the occasion. Every action has its repercussions. We are parents that to lay down the foundation. So as a concerned parent, this is my plan. To save the future generation. We just cannot continue in this way. Don't allow an influence to lead you astray. And may God bless our nation as we move in this positive direction.
Joke it, joke it, joke it right
that she like it. She tell me that joking like that she like it. Joking! Hey! Woo! Yeah. On our speed! Watch out, watch out! We got it again!
Joke it!
musical chairs. Come forward. Come. Put your hands together one more time for the musical chair with us. Now I must let you people know though, do not take this cultural outreach program at face value. Because I must tell you all that there's a certain element in this country who do not want to see the children play, who do not want to see the children sing, who do not want to see the children dance, who don't want to hear the children sing their calypso, who don't want the children to understand their culture. So please, do not take this little gathering at face value. And you must make every effort to join this outreach program so that we can have our culture distributed equitably amongst our children and our seed and our offspring. Could you put your hands together one more time for the children on the coffee? Okay, my brother, I thank you again. King Solomon, drive safely. Brother Mark, would you like to have any closing remarks? Well, could we please come together as we close our cultural evening? I would like to invite each and everyone to come join with us as we close our cultural evening.
become the wise and prudent will now be revealed to babes and sucklings. And after the children say, don't you worry, I am telling you, the parents and the grandparents, and those of you listening as elders, to don't worry. Uprising Stars Cultural say, we wish you safe journey back home, and God bless until next week.
Yeah. Hey. Good night, kids. Sleep well, lovely having you this evening.
Like every human being in the world, we have been afraid. But you still sing it. We are not afraid. We are not afraid. And I'd especially like to dedicate this verse to an old friend of mine. I think she's the oldest person here tonight. Aunt Hollis Pollitzer.